Hey guys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag, coming at you on late afternoon on Tuesday, the 22nd, I think, or 23rd. I've been keeping busy a little bit. Last weekend I got home from, I was gone for a week in Las Vegas, so I got home last week and Friday night, and then I came out here Saturday and Sunday, did a little painting, more painting. I have more stuff to do than you can imagine, but one of the things I did was I put the U-joints in my drive shaft, and I was reading the comments that Ziggy posted, or I listened to the video that Ziggy posted about giving it a wrap to loosen it up, so I thought maybe I'd give that a try. I'll show you guys what mine look like, and then we'll see whether we can take advantage of some tribal knowledge with Ziggy. So there's my drive shaft. Not real long. Nothing like the one that was in the Nova from Yahubin. This has got an adjustment on it here. You know, so it has a spline shaft. I guess this is to make it possible to put it in and take it out. I suppose that's one way. And I put new U-joints in here. These are all brand new. Painted up the yokes and everything the other day. And this, you know, that's not terrible, right? It's actually pretty loose. It might have loosened up just sitting around. But I felt like it was real stiff the other day. And then this one's a little stiffer. So I've got to give it a pretty good push to turn it. So this will be one that we can experiment with. So Ziggy's idea is to get the vise just up in that corner, although it might be a little hard to get at it. So we'll give it a try. Okay, Ziggy, since I can't get at the back side of that because this round flange is in the way, I figured out I could lay it down on my vise like this, and I could get a drift pin through there and maybe give it a little, try and wake those flanges back out a little bit. So that's what I'm going to give a try. See if I can get my drift pin down in there. Like you said, you don't need a lot, right? But I just want to get on the top of that, not on the cup, but just on the top of the metal or the steel. I don't think I have clearance. Nope. Too fat. So let's see. I've got something else here maybe I can use. Nope. Too fat. Holy cow. You have to be really thin. Maybe not. Maybe we can't do this. Got a piece of stainless steel here. Maybe that'll hold up to the hammer. It's a little thinner. Yeah, there we go. Now I've come home to the edge of the yoke on the outside of the cap. One on each side, maybe. We'll flip it over and do the same thing to the other half. The dust cap. There we go. Okay. So I gave that a good bang. Marginally better, not substantially. Still pretty stiff. But you know, it's a brand new U-joint, and I'm thinking, well, that's just life with U-joints. You know, when they're new, they're going to be, you know, a little stiff. This one's a little looser back here, so I get that
that this one might be a tad tight, but I'm not sure I can release it. I can't get at it well enough to give it a wrap, so I think I'm going to accept what I have. But it was worth a try. Thanks, Ziggy.
Sorry about that. Almost dropped you.
So, yeah, Ruben, my shaft is not as long as yours. Sorry. Well, not sorry, but maybe I'm sorry. Jag E-type drive shafts are not that big. You can see here, it's only... Now, here, I'll put it down by the bench, and you can see it's just barely not even the height of my bench from the floor. So, pretty short. And then worked on my turn signal switch today. Took it all apart, completely broke it down into individual pieces, took all the springs and contacts out of it, cleaned it, put it back together, tested it for continuity. It's all good. And it turns out that there is a replacement handle that I can buy, which I'm really happy to hear, because my turn signal handle was rusted beyond recognition and all the chrome had come off it. So I wire-wheeled the rest of the chrome off it thinking, well, maybe I could polish the steel, but boy, it's so badly pitted. It just doesn't look good. You know, you can see the pits in the... This camera won't really focus this close up, but you can see the pits anyway, even in this light. So I can get a brand new one of these handles from XK's Unlimited. They have them in their catalog. I expect the other guys might have them, but I didn't see them in any of their other catalogs. So that's all done. And then something else I did, which I'll just show off my workmanship here. I got the inside of the headlight housing sprayed in metallic silver. So I sprayed these two with rattle bombs, but boy, they sure came out nice. I had two coats of primer. Did a little wet sanding on the primer to get it, you know, looking good. And then I just used a little rattle bomb from AutoZone or O'Reilly's Auto Parts. And it was this stuff for Chrysler. Matches original Chrysler silver metallic. Radiant silver metallic. There you go. Looks great. I also have some Duplicolor engine enamel in silver that I was going to try, but I stuck with the body paint that turned out okay. So, and I painted my canister, guys. Remember the air filter canister? We've been talking about it for a while. And I painted it with Rattle Bomb enamel, but it's coming along. It's got a couple of dry spots here because it was turned the other way up on its top. So I need to come back in here, get those spots, and then do the bottom as well. But I'm pretty happy with the way the outside of the canister turned out. I had to do a little spray, a little body work on it in a couple of spots. It was pretty banged up right over here, right in this area. And I hammered and dollied some of that out. It's a lot better than it was. I had a huge flat spot. And you can see here it's pretty ragged. That's where the bracket goes, so that'll be covered by the mounting bracket, and the side of the car covers it up to here, so you won't even see that, just see the top part. So anyway, I'm pretty happy with the way that turned out. I got all the rust out of it. I actually ended up pouring my rust remover stuff in there rather than using my electrolysis rust removing. I never did boot that up. I read a couple more comments from guys that have used that technique before, and they all said, you know, it's line of sight, it's only going to do, you know, certain spots, it's not really going to do the whole, it's not going to do the whole thing, it's only going to do what can be seen where the electrode is. And that was kind of bumming me out. So I bought another gallon of this evaporust stuff instead of I was using Metal Rescue for a lot of my stuff, but I bought evaporust, so I just poured about a quart of it down in there, and it filled that whole bottom section. I let it soak overnight, you know, swizzled it around, shook it up good, dumped it out, put some soapy water, hot water in there, rinsed it out real good. And then there was still some grease in there that I could see, so I put some solvent, paint thinner, in there, and then shook that around a little bit, and then rinsed it out again real good, and then it came up real nice. I mean, I let it dry and sprayed it. I'm not really spraying down in there. I just wanted to get all the rust out of it. So I think we did a good job there. What else can I talk about? I did the horns. I took them all apart. Completely, you know, took the lid and electrical connection points off. And I soaked these rubber connections in Armor All for a couple days to get them, you know, soften them up a little bit, and then sprayed the cover, and then sprayed the horn.
and the little trumpet area here, which is kind of cute. I got two of them, high and low. I tested them tonight, but it made my dogs bark. So I stopped. And I guess I haven't really made a video since I had my birthday. Did I? I don't know. Maybe I made one and I didn't post it. I've been really busy. But I wanted, you know, for my birthday, I wanted to get a HVLP spray gun from, you know, Harbor Freight. So I got it. Here it is here. I got the purple one. You know, I read some postings from guys that they make a couple that are pretty good. And I tried to get the one that everybody was saying worked pretty good. So comes with one tip. But I think it can use multiple tips, and a little 20-ounce canister here. So, you know, it's cheap, but, you know, I'm a beginner. I don't really know what I'm doing, and I was telling Hansen on his videos the other day, I got to learn how to do all this stuff. And what I mainly have to do is I have to get the chemicals to clean the gun. So I don't think I should use paint thinner, but, I mean, I hear a lot of guys talking about gun cleaning liquid. And then I hear other guys talking about, you know, reducer, that you can use that, or lacquer thinner. So I'm confused. And this thing says in the manual you can use paint thinner. But I think paint thinner's got some stuff in it that doesn't really, I don't know, it doesn't really work as well, I think. And then I got a gun cleaning kit. So it came with a couple brushes in the kit here, too. And a wrench, which is cool, and a little bit of grease, I think they call it. There's one point where you're supposed to put some grease once in a blue moon, and then this spray gun cleaning kit, which some of which will be helpful, and some of it. This one looks like an old basting brush that we had when I was a little kid. My mom used to use that for barbecue sauce. Anyhow, it didn't cost a lot of money, so I got it. So yeah, that's cool. Birthday presents are always fun. And PDQ, I wanted to tell you something. I was reading on my JAG owners group that's called jag-lovers.org that a guy had said, oh, check out this eBay auction from somebody that was auctioning off a 1/8 scale E-type hardtop, just like mine, Series 1 coupe. And, you know, I wasn't like that excited about it at first, and then I started thinking about how fun that would be. And then I read the description of this kit. It was made by, now the name won't come out of my head. The really famous one, anyway, Revell owns them now from Germany, but they were an American kit maker. And, they still have a website and everything, you know, you can go up there. And I asked the guys on the website if they had the instructions anymore, because I have the old ones, but they're really yellowed and brittle. But they said, no, we don't have those anymore. So it's like 1,000 pieces. It's really detailed and it's big. So when it's done, it's going to be about that big. I think it'll be fun. So I'm kind of looking forward to putting that together. And maybe I'll have to ask for some advice, you know, from you, the expert model builder. But I thought that might be fun when the car is done. Give myself something else to do on nights and weekends. So, other things I'm working on, there's a turn signal switch housing that goes on the steering shaft that needs to be sprayed. So I just stripped that today after I worked on the switch, electric switch. There's this mechanical, you know, housing that it goes into, and then that clamps around the steering column. So I'll get that done, and you know, I've been talking about putting that rear suspension in the car, and I realized I needed to get the drive shaft done before I could put the rear suspension cage up into the car. So I think now I've done everything that drive shaft's been scrubbed, clean, stripped, painted, new universal joints put in it. I need to grease it real good. I have one of these little cheapy grease guns, you know, the hand pump ones, but it's not pumping grease. I don't know what's wrong. Maybe I have a bad cartridge. Maybe I have a bad gun. Both. Who knows? But I'll get that working, or if not, I'll go get another one, or go to the gas station or somewhere, you know, repair center, and ask them to put some grease in it for me. And then put that thing up under the car. That'll be cool. I can get my old wheels out and put the thing on wheels. That'll be also a big milestone day. And then once it's on wheels, I can climb in and out of it. You know, I'm a little wary of climbing into the car right now because it's on, two pretty strong welded on caster, stands in the back. But the ones in the front are just these little, you know, small jack stands. And the car is very light. And so when you move around, you can feel it slipping and sliding. It just doesn't make me feel good. And I need, that's kind of where, once the suspensions are on and it's on its four wheels, then I can get in and start doing the wiring. But I really need to get in the cockpit and be working in the dash area to put that main harness in. So then I'll be doing that. So it'll be fun stuff. That's it. I got my wiper assembly put back together. I got a video on that. I'll stick that up. So that's over here on the car, the whole wiper transmission kind of multi-link assembly that drives the three windshield wipers. This is kind of a cool car. It's got three windshield wipers across the windshield. So one in the middle is driven and the other two slave off of that center one. That's all ready to go in. My drive shaft for steering column, the inner shaft with all of its new joints, I put those in. So I got U-joints galore. Little U-joints, big U-joints. It's all good. It's all real good. So, yeah. Weather's great. Oh, yeah, weather. Hey, John Kerry day, man. Let me show you.
Awesome day today. You got 80, looks like 83, or in Celsius, that looks like it's about 28, and it was just a beautiful day today, just gorgeous, really gorgeous, sunshine, blue sky, birds tweeting, squirrels bouncing around. Look at the leaves on these oak trees. Normally these oak trees, they call them scrub oak because you can kind of look at the shape of them. You know, they kind of look scrubby and scraggly. And normally they don't have a lot of green on them. And boy, they just have really exploded this year, which is unusual. We have two or three different kinds of oaks. This is another kind of an oak tree, this one over here. And they always have a lot of greenery. That's called a live oak. And I've got another one like that growing on my neighbor's yard over here. And I've got another live oak right there that's doing real well. Actually, there's a pair of them. Yeah, so this is an oak tree kind of area. We have a lot of, look at that thing over there on the top of my neighbor's. That's in his yard, in his back. That thing's huge. That must be, it must be 50 feet, maybe? That's really big, top to bottom. So anyway, gorgeous day. Flowers are blooming. Bees are buzzing, birds are tweeting. I'm a happy camper working out in the garage. Looks great, feels great. So I hope everybody's having a good week. I know I didn't post anything up, so this will be my catch up from last week and the week before because I've been out of town. Repeating myself now. So okay, everybody. Have a good day. Or good night. Bye.